Hey guys, thanks for tuning in to CMTEQ channel in this series of tutorial on fault current calculations. So this is tutorial 2. Now here we have a problem statement that says a three phase, okay, 1500 kilovolt ampere, that's a 1.5 mega MVA, okay, 1.5 MVA transformer having a percentage reactance of 4.5%. Now it is supplied with a 6.6 kilovolt generator, okay, that is rated at 2 MVA, all right, and a percentage reactance of 12% of the generator. Now the transformer secondary potential is 33 kilovolt. Now what does it mean? It means it's a step up transformer. Obviously we're taking from a generator, stepping it up for transmission, and it is connected to a transmission line, okay, of resistance of 1.5 ohm per kilometer and reactance of 0.3 ohm per kilometer. So you can see this is a resistance and reactance of the cable, but they are not giving us the total resistance of the cable, but they are telling us that it is a 1.5 ohm and 0.3 ohm resistance and reactance respectively per kilometer. Okay, so what's the question? The question here is to calculate the primary short circuit current and the short circuit MVA, okay, when a three-phase symmetrical short circuit occurs in the line at point 20 kilometers. So the line can be a 100 kilometer line, but they are only telling us to calculate the short circuit at a 20 kilometer point from the transformer on a base of 2000 kilo volt ampere, 2 MVA, that's going to be the base, okay? So the fault is occurring at 20 kilometer from the transformer, okay, not from the generator but from the transformer, which is stepping up from a 6.6 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt for transmission. Now the next thing to do here is first to draw the schematic, draw just to illustrate your problem statement, put it on paper, and this is what we get. So an illustration here, we have a 6.6 kilovolt generator at 2 MVA, 12% percentage reactance, and we have a transformer that is connected right at the generating station, and that is stepping up from a 6.6 kilovolt to 33 kilovolt for the transmission line. Now here is our transmission line, and they say the fault occurred at 0.20 kilometer from the transformer, so that would be this point here, so that's a 20 kilometer point, and this is our load. That means the load is not going to be receiving any power since there is a fault there at that point. So now we need to calculate what is the short circuit current, okay, the what is the primary short circuit current that is going to be at this point, and the primary and the short circuit MVA also at that point. Now this is a good illustration, but we can also have an elevated illustrations that is similar to a real life scenario, and we're going to have here a generator and a transformer, okay, the power transformer, and we have our transmission line. So and this is the load. We're just making an example that our load here could be this motor here, but they say that we have a fault at 20 kilometer from the transformer, so it could be somewhere here. So our fault could be somewhere there, the 20 kilometer point, or it can also be somewhere here after the pylon. So that is a scenario we have there, and if we've got a fault there, that means the motor here is going to be deprived from receiving the power. Okay, so now we need to move on and calculate what have been demanded and calculate what is required from us. But before we do that, please consider subscribing to CMTEQ channel right now and hit the subscribe button. That will be highly appreciated. Okay, so now in order to calculate the short circuit current and the short circuit MVA, we need to find the per unit. So now the per unit of what? The per unit of the generator, the transformer, and the line. Okay, so now I've done a couple of per unit tutorial on this channel. You are welcome to browse my channel and find yourself a good per unit tutorial that is going to help you. But in the description box, I've included a link for tutorial 1 and tutorial 2 on the per unit series that can be very helpful. Okay, now moving forward here, this is a general formula for the per unit. If you understand this formula, then the next thing here is only to replace a value, and we will be able to find the generator per unit of generator 1 to be 0,12. Now, if you don't know how we go to this value, the formula that I just showed now is exactly what we used, and you are welcome to watch the per unit tutorial. And then for transformer 2, we found the per unit of 0.06 J per unit. Okay, now we can move on to then calculate the per unit for the cable. Okay, now we know that the problem statement says that the cable, okay, which is used on the transmission line, have a resistance of 1.5 ohm per kilometer and a reactance of 0.3 ohm per kilometer. Now, what does it mean? Well, since the fault here is occurring at 0.20 kilometer, that means all these values, 1.5 ohm per kilometer, must be multiplied times 20 in order to find the correct resistance value for this line at 0.20 kilometer. And the reactance will also do exactly the same. But we have to also know what is the zone voltage. The zone voltage is obviously 33 kilovolt for that section. Okay, and that will then mean we're going to have R per kilometer will be 1.5 times 20, that will be 30 ohm for the 20 kilometer section, and also a reactance of 6 ohm for the 20 kilometer section. Now, from here, we know that these values here are our Z actual, because we know with our per unit tutorial that we've seen previously, we know that the per unit value of the line here is equal to the Z actual, okay, which is then consists of this value divided by the Z base. Z base what? The Z base of the section based on the voltage. So our Z actual of the line is then 30 plus 6J, and converting it into polar form, we get 30.6 with an angle of 11.31 degrees. Okay, now the formula for the Z per unit of the line is obviously Z actual over ZB, and ZB being equal to VB of the zone divided by VB SB new, and SB new is the 2000 kilovolt ampere, which is 2 MVA. So that is the new base that we are calculating the system. Now we can calculate, then we found a ZB of 544.5 ohm. That is by replacing using this formula. Now moving on, we can then deduce the value of the Z per unit of the line. That is equal to Z actual divided by ZB. We know what's the value of Z actual, and this gives us the value of 0,0562 with an angle of 11.3331 degrees, and converting it back into a rectangular form, we found the value of 0,055 plus 0,011J. So this is the resistive component, and this one here is the inductive component in per unit form for our transmission line. Okay, now pay attention to the next point here. The next point here is, in order to calculate the short circuit current that is going to be flowing into the circuit at this point here, we need to calculate the total per unit impedance. Now, the total per unit impedance is simply the addition of all these per unit of the generator, of the transformer, and of the transmission line. And these are the value that we just calculated here. So Z per unit total will then be equal to Z per unit of the generator, of the transformer, and of the line as well. And that will give us a total per unit impedance of 0,1 0.99 with an angle of 73.9 degrees. Basically, it's 0.2 with an angle of 74 degrees. Okay, so now moving forward, we can then calculate the short circuit current. Now, what's the formula of the short circuit current? Now, the formula of the short circuit current is given by I short circuit is equal to I per unit times I line. Now, what is I per unit? I per unit, we know that I per unit is 1 over Z per unit. Now, Z per unit is the total impedance, per unit impedance from this point here up to this point. So there is a per unit value here. There is 1 there and 1 on the line. So we added everything, and that's going to be the total per unit impedance. Okay, and then we found a value of 5,031 at an angle of 73. Now this angle should be a negative angle as per the rules. Okay, now what's the next thing? That is then to calculate I line. Now remember, we are calculating the short circuit current, okay, on the primary side. That is this side. You remember that the current on the primary here is not the same current that is flowing on the secondary. This one here is a smaller current compared to this one because the voltages have gone up, so the current must go down to maintain the transformer properties. Okay, so we then going to use the zone voltage here of 6.6 kilovolt that is on the generator side. So that will then be given by the formula Ilan is equal to SP nu over VB zone. Now, what is VB zone? VB zone is this one here, the 6.6 kilovolt, not the 33. Now, if we were calculating for the fault at this on the secondary side, okay, then we will be using 33 kilovolt. Since we are calculating on the primary side, then we have to use Ilan with the zone voltage on the primary side of the transformer. So we found a 174.95 amps. Okay, now from here we can then replace the value since we got the I line and we have I per unit, and then we know that our short circuit current is going to be equal to 880.2 amps. Basically, that is the multiplications of the I per unit times the I line. So now moving forward, and please don't forget to subscribe to CMTEQ channel and give this tutorial a thumbs up if you find it helpful. Now finishing off, we then have to calculate the short circuit MVA. Now the short circuit MVA is going to be calculated by the same formula that we calculated I per unit, I calculated I line, but this time we just have to replace Island with a short circuit, and from there we can draw the short circuit MVA as shown below, and that will then be equal to square root of 3 times 6.6 times 10 to the power 3. Remember, it is from the primary side of the transformer, and we find a value of 10.06 MVA short circuit volt ampere. Okay, so that is it for this tutorial. So the few points that you have to note in this tutorial is when you are calculating the fault current, you have to make sure where are you calculating, where is the fault occurring, what's the direction of the current. So we know that the current is flowing this way because the fault is at 0.20. So that means the transformer here is now going to pulling everything it has. Since that is now happening, that means the current on the primary here is also going to be on its maximum, the short circuit current, and that is what we just calculated there. Okay, so please guys, don't forget to subscribe to CMTEQ channel and give this tutorial a thumbs up, and that will be highly appreciated. Stay tuned for the next tutorial on CMTEQ channel. Cheers.